James Bradberry already has two interceptions on this young season, but I know, hey, you're all about winning, and the team had a real big one in New Orleans last week. What's the atmosphere and emotion like? Can that provide a big spark as you go to Dallas?
I think it definitely gives us a spark. It gives us a little momentum going into the next week. We know Dallas is a tough opponent, and we definitely need that win from last week in order to give us some energy, some confidence.
Now, one thing I noticed about Dallas, this is a team that scored at least 29 points in three of their first four games this year. Yet, they don't have a lot of long explosive plays. It's more short stuff and getting yak yardage. How does that change your perspective as a defensive back?
Well, like you said, they don't have a lot of explosive plays. So, you know, they're like kind of like dinking and dunking and getting yards after the catch. CeeDee Lamb, Amari Cooper are great guys to get the ball to. Because, you know, they're elusive in the open field. And also, they've been running the ball pretty well with Tony Pollard and also Ezekiel Elliott. So they have a high-powered offense. You just want to definitely attack them. And you never want explosive plays, so you want to keep them in front of you. But limit the yards after catch, for sure.
So how do these Cowboys receivers differ from one another, whether it's Cooper, whether it's Lamb? And then people can't forget about Schultz at the tight end spot. He's been dangerous for them.
Yeah, well, Schultz, I'll start off with him because he's been under the radar because everybody gives all their attention to CeeDee Lamb and Amari Cooper. But he's a good tight end, a pass-catching tight end. Definitely shows up in the red zone a lot. And Amari Cooper and CeeDee Lamb, they're kind of similar but different. I believe Amari Cooper's a little bigger. So he's a little tougher to tackle because of his size. CeeDee Lamb's a little bit more elusive with the ball in his hands. But they're both great route runners. They definitely do a good job attacking the ball at the highest point.
Is part of their danger also with the extension of plays when Prescott does decide to move around a little bit? How good are they as a receiving group in terms of making things happen for him?
Sure. They're good by themselves, but then when you add a great quarterback like Dak, you know, I think that puts them in the category of elite. You know, those three together, they make an elite combination. I think that's what definitely makes them so tough to guard in this league.
Defensive coordinator Patrick Graham had told us about a month or so ago that the first few weeks of the season, there will be some gelling going on, and it will take you a while to hit your stride. Do you think you're starting to get there? How close are you?
I think we're getting better week in and week out. We're coming off the win, so we got more confidence this week. So we're going to continue to build upon that chemistry and hopefully keep building it each week in and week out.
Final question. If there's one thing that you'd really like to see this defense improve on and clean up, what would that be?
Create more turnovers. We definitely got to get the ball back to our offense more. You know, that's part of my job as a corner to create turnovers, and that's what I'm looking to do.
You're a defensive back. I expected that.
Yeah, for sure.
James Bradberry, always good to see you. Thanks for your time. Best of luck.
Thank you for having me.